In this video, you will understand the advantage of using Phoenix LiveView campaign with React. But first of all, I'm not going to say that React is bad. This is my experience and why I prefer Phoenix LiveView. So in this video, you understand a few topics that I explained related to the difference between both and the advantage that I see in Phoenix LiveView and React. Let's start by talking about Phoenix LiveView. So Phoenix and the advantage, I think Phoenix about productivity. You can get more things done coding less. For example, when you start a Phoenix LiveView project, things that you're going to notice is that when you start the project, you're going to have a set of database, you're going to have the set up of tests for whatever environment. You have the environments default like testing, dev, and production done. Also, you don't need to install frameworks for testing. You don't need to install frameworks for the database. It's not like, hey, I need handling with the database, so install something using the NPM, PNPM, or Yard. Also, when we talk about the productivity, we are talking about that you have the default frameworks that you don't need to search for more frameworks to use. So you can just study a small block of frameworks and start coding. And the advantage is that, as I mentioned to you, test for me is very important. Because when you test your application, you feel comfortable to do refactor about the architecture, refactor about code, refactor about folders, and whatever. Also, it increases the productivity because if someone refactor your code or fix bugs, you're going to see tests broken. So for me, this is one of the advantages. Also, testing with Phoenix LiveView is so easy to start. So that are some advantages that I saw with using Phoenix. Also, when we think about framework, as I mentioned to you, you don't need to install frameworks such as security, such as handling with the HTML or the frameworks with design because you already have the tailwind as default. And when we think about the security, you don't need to install, for example, frameworks to handle with the authentication. By default, you can use the genauth, and then you have the whole authentication done with one step. Of course, you need to understand the files, but this is another topic. But that is one of the biggest advantage. When we talk about React and frameworks, you need to install a lot of frameworks to handle with the security, with routers, and you have like a standard with Phoenix LiveView. Thinking about React, one of the advantages that I saw with React is that you have a lot of frameworks, a lot of flexibilities with UI. But when you think about Elixir and Phoenix, you can simply install frameworks using the JS, and you have to use the hooks, which require a bit of knowledge about the JavaScript, but this is something that you can handle with that. But 95% you can handle with the Phoenix and Live. Also, another thing that I saw is that when you use React, I don't know how it works with Next now, but you can just, as I mentioned, you have a block of frameworks, but with React, you need to consume APIs and then handling it with the server. With Elixir, Phoenix, and LiveView, you have the real-time change into the database and the UI quickly. So also, you don't need to consume APIs or something like that. You can just access the server and do stuff. Talking about the disadvantage, let's start with the disadvantage of React. However, React has its own challenge set to handle. For example, as I mentioned, related to the tests, testing React application can be quite complex. So I noticed that you have to install frameworks and you don't have like the full framework to use. I test using React with Jest most of my time, but I felt challenges when I had to install frameworks and then start testing something like that. When I mentioned about the full stack development, managing both front end and back end for a full stack development is required. It's like you need to understand the back end, you need to understand the front end, a lot of things. Of course, you need to do that, but you just have one language, and the language is just one application, which makes this deploy easier. But when you think about the React, you need to create the front end with React and then deploy the back end in different servers, which is something for me, it takes time in managing and creating your own project with both, like full stack development. It's quite hard. Now, let's get into my personal thoughts on why I prefer Phoenix LiveView again. So, as I mentioned about the productivity, for me, something that is very important, especially about the development process. So, you can save time deploying, testing, and producing a good code. Testing, as I mentioned to me, to you, is very important. And building code with LiveView is straightforward and less cumbersome. Framework, as I mentioned, you do need to build new frameworks. They consume a lot of frameworks to build LiveView applications. And deploying with Phoenix LiveView is way more simpler. When we talk about the security, LiveView provides great security for interactive applications. So my challenges with React, on the other hand, with React, building tests is quite complex. I mentioned to you the Fullstack development you need to handle with the APIs, and which is something for me, consume time, and also you need to manage two applications. To wrap up, Phoenix LiveView has significantly improved my workflow and productivity, simplicity. And for me, LiveView makes it a good choice compared with the Fullstack development, because you just need to handle with one application and you can keep it simple and stupid. I would love to hear your thoughts and experience with these technologies in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, let me know. Give me a thumbs up. If that makes sense to you, subscribe to learn more about the Elixir. As I mentioned, for me, it's not React is a bad framework, but this is my experience as a Fullstack development. Bye.